guys, so what we're gonna do is elimination three times. Okay. So the first two eliminations that you have to do, you have to pick a combination of two equations, and obviously you can't pick the same two for each part, and you want to cancel a variable. You pick, all right, whatever you want to cancel first. So in this case, the z's totally look the easiest, all right? You should go with the z's. But it really will work if you want to cancel y's or you want to cancel x's. It doesn't matter, but you have to cancel the same variable both times, all right? So let's go with z's. And just so we know what we're talking about, I'm going to label these 1, 2, and 3. All right, so equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3. And we're going to start by canceling the z's. We have to do two different problems here, so I'm going to first use equations 1 and 2. Now, these you could add in your head, but I'm going to rewrite just to show you that we're doing elimination 3 times. So I'm using equation number 1 with equation number 2, and we're going to cancel the z's. So we add down, and we get 3x, and we add down, we get just y, and our z's cancel, and then we get 4. Now you have to cancel the same variable for the next step. And you can use any combination you want to besides the ones we just used. So we used 1 and 2, so now your choices are 1 and 3 or 2 and 3. Which one is easiest? 1 and 3 or 2 and 3? Probably 2 and 3. Again, it doesn't matter. If you use 1 and 3, it works. You just have to multiply by a negative, right? So I'm going to use 2 and 3 so I don't have to do that step. And so just to show you, I'm going to rewrite. And you may have to actually multiply by something to do this step, but this one was set up nicely for us where you guys picked the right variable, and it's an easy one to cancel, okay? So now I'm going to use equations 2 and 3, and I'm going to cancel the z's again. So I get 4x, negative 3y, z's cancel, and I get what? Alright, once we're down to these two equations, we now get to do elimination with what's left over. So now I just have x and y, and I just have x and y. So that's why you have to cancel the same variable.
Can you do substitution?
Yes. You could, yeah. Nope. I'm going to do elimination though. So all I'm going to do is write this up here. So 4x minus 3y equals 1. Okay, easier to cancel the x's or the y's, you guys?
Y.
The y's. What should I multiply by?
3.
3 and the top, okay? So I'm going to multiply this equation by 3, and I'm just going to write it down below. So this would be 9x plus 3y. And don't forget to multiply all the way across. And our y's cancel. And I get 13x equals 13, which means that x equals 1. Okay, there are two places to plug in now to find y. Don't go back to the originals yet. You want to go back to either this equation or this equation, one of them that just has two variables, okay? So I'm going to go back right here. It doesn't matter, but I'm going to go here. So 4, plug in a 1. Okay, subtract 4 from both sides, so that gives me negative 3, and we get 1. Okay, now that we know two variables, you can go back to any of the three original equations. Okay, so I'm just going to use this top equation. We know x is 1, we now know y is 1, so that's 2 plus, or plus 1 is 3, subtract, so what do we get for z? And we get 1. And then you have to write it as a coordinate. X, Y, Z. This one happens to all be 1, 1, 1. Okay? So elimination 3 times. Let's do... Alright. So you guys want to do X or Y. It really does not matter, but
y,
X or Y. Alright, we're going to do Y. Alright, so again, I'm going to label this equation 1, and this equation 2, and this equation 3. So, it'd be probably best. equation 2 by 2, because then you'd have a positive 2y, and then you can actually use 1 and 2 and 2 and 3 the same. You only have to do that one step. So I'm going to do equation 1 and 2 first. So 1 and 2. So I'm going to rewrite equation 1. And then I'm going to multiply through by 2 on this second equation. Be careful when you do this. Make sure you don't make a mistake, because then it messes everything up. So then we have plus 2y, and then we have minus 2z, and then we have 6. All right, something interesting is going to happen. So what do I get for my x's? 3x. What happens to my y's? What happens to my z's? What happens over here? 8. All right, so we end up just getting x. So if you end up getting x, you can pretty much just plug x in, and then you're down to two variables and two unknowns. So I'm going to pick these two equations here, 2 and 3. And I'm just going to plug x in as 8 thirds for both equations. So I have 8 thirds, and then plus y, this is equation 2, minus z equals 3. So equation 2 before we multiplied by 2. And then I'm going to rewrite equation 3, and I'm going to plug in 8 thirds. Elimination by getting our numbers all moved to the other side here. So we just have y and z. So I'm going to subtract 8 thirds, and I'm going to subtract 8 thirds. So this cancels, and now this equation is y minus z. We need to rewrite 3 as 9 thirds. So 9 thirds minus 8 thirds is 1 third. Okay, when you do 3 times 8 thirds, the 3's cancel, so that's nice. And then I have minus 8 and minus 8, so now I have negative 2y minus 2z equals negative 6. And we're down to like a normal elimination problem. Do you guys want to cancel y's or z's?
Goal.
Okay, I'm going to go with y's, so I'm going to multiply this by 2. That'll give me a positive 2y and a negative 2z. And then you still have to do 2 times 1 third, so that's 2 thirds. The y's cancel. We get negative 4z. We need to make this out of 3, so times by 3, we get negative 18 sixths or thirds, and then plus 2. Negative 16 thirds. Good old fractions.
I hate fractions.
Yeah. Times by negative 1 fourth here. The reciprocal. So z. Right here we can cross cancel 4 and 16. And then a negative times a negative is a positive 4 thirds. So we've got x and we've got z. I would probably just go back to this one, y minus z equals 1 third. So now I've got y minus 4 thirds equals 1 third. So we can add 4 thirds.